Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's CJ here again. Welcome back to the Empire. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please make sure you do that by hitting that subscription bell. Anyway, enough of the talk, enough of the intro. So what am I doing in this video? I did a video on how much it's going to cost you to, you know, come up with a makeup kit. So then I got another question: how do I build up my makeup kit, y'all? Now this is a bit interesting because I think you build up your makeup kit as you go. But the first thing that I want to share with you how I build up my makeup kit, and the experience is a bit overwhelming at some point. It got a bit overwhelming at some point. I got broke. I got bankrupt at some point because yo, makeup is expensive. But the truth of the matter is, all of us are going to start from dubois, whether we like it or not, like a big majority, because I think like the people that are my audience is like the middle class people who love wearing makeup. The truth of the matter is, all of us are going to start from dubois. All of us, like most of us, we buy makeup from dubois, because when I started buying makeup from dubois, I had no idea there's anything like fake makeup and legit makeup. I had no clue at all. Me and you, you want makeup, go to dubois. You wanna get you know, anything related to beauty, go to dubois. I had no idea that dubois was a street full of fake things and everything like that. But as the, you know, as people came by and makeup became so much more of a thing here in Kenya, that's when we realized, oh, oops, there's fake makeup and there's legit makeup and all that kind of stuff. So how do you build your kit? Truth of the matter is, you will build your kit as you go. So what I did, what happened to me is that once I began being interested in makeup, the first things obviously that you want to know how to do is obviously it's your brows. There's no way you're gonna start doing makeup if you don't know how to do your brows. I don't know if that applies to everyone, but I think brows is the most important thing for you to know. So what I did, I started practicing on my eyebrows. So when I started practicing on my eyebrows, I had to know, I did my research, and I realized that when it comes to your brows, you're gonna need an eyebrow pencil, you're gonna need a concealer, and you're not gonna need a spoolie brush, and you're gonna need an angled brush to clean my brows. Like lately people are even using flat brushes to clean their brows, but when makeup was, you know, becoming slowly getting popularism, it was all about angled brushes. So I learned to do my eyebrows using angled brushes, a concealer, and an eyebrow pencil from dubois. So what I did is, because I wanted to start with my brows, so I started practicing with my brows. So the first kit I bought, the easiest way for you to build your kit, the first thing I bought was a concealer, an eyebrow pencil, a spoolie brush, and an angled brush. Then I did my brows. I perfected my brows. I could take like 2 hours doing my brows just to be perfect. I could take forever. Like I was that person, if it doesn't turn out good, I would feel so bad about it, and I would do it the entire day. Yo, I used to spend hours and hours in the mirror trying to do my brows, and it was crazy, okay? So I perfected my brows. Then from there, I wanted to know how to do my eyeshadows. Then, okay, so I already have a concealer, which I already bought at 100 shillings. Then I have a concealer. And then all these things, mind you, I'm buying them from dubois. So I already have a concealer at 100 shillings, the spoolie brushes at 100 shillings and everything. So what next? I need to buy an eyeshadow palette. My first eyeshadow palette was, this was my first eyeshadow palette. This is a Jaclyn Hill by Morphe, supposedly. This was my first, I don't know, yeah, this is how you guys can see it. This was my first eyeshadow palette that I got from dubois at 1,000 shillings. So I had to save up for 1,000 shillings. I had to save up, like, you know, it depends on the kind of job that you do. But I had to save up and get 1,000 bob and buy me this after so many weeks of, you know, saving and, you know, also trying to perfect my brows so that when I go down, it's like, you know, I'm going in a symmetrical kind of way. So this was my first eyeshadow palette. It was 1,000 shillings. Initially, I had no idea or clue that I could get a palette that could serve me all purposes. A palette that could serve me as a powder palette, as a contour palette, and also as an eyeshadow palette. So in this video, I would recommend for you to get a palette that can have so many purposes for you to save a lot of money. If it's original, you want to get like Kara. Kara can serve you a lot of purpose. It can do your eyeshadows, it can do your blush, it can do your contour powders, and it can also do your face powder. So you want to get yourself Kara. But the next thing I bought was an eyeshadow palette. So you don't have to buy so many eyeshadow palettes, just get one eyeshadow palette that can serve a lot of purposes. Okay, it's good that I'm here to show you, to tell you guys that one palette can serve a lot of purposes for you guys. But I had no idea, I had no clue of such things. Okay, so I went ahead and bought an eyeshadow palette. So the next thing from my eyebrows was my eyeshadow palette. Okay, for lipstick, I can say everyone from dubois, not even if you don't wear makeup, no one doesn't have a lipstick. Like on those days, all of us used to wear signature. I can't even remember the last time I wore that lipstick. The one that is signature is, to be precise, 107 was the shade. So yeah, for lipstick, everyone has lipsticks. Dubois lipsticks are like 100 shillings. I ditched them because they started blackening my lips. My lips began to get darker and they started cracking, so I just had to stop using them. But after I discovered this original lipstick, that's what I noticed. Oh my goodness, my lips are changing in color and everything. So I had to ditch them, I had to stop. So eyeshadow was the next thing that I got. So we are still going down. So after I've done my eyeshadow, I noticed, oh, I want to go down to my face. So what else? I need a primer. Obviously, you do boys, primer, a fake primer, 150 shillings. You get yourself a primer. Next thing, what do I need? I need a foundation. I went down there to dubois, bought myself a foundation. And then, oh, now I have eyeshadows. I have brow stuff. And then now I have, like, foundation, and then I have a primer. Oh, so I need to blend my primer, I need to blend my foundation. What do I need? A beauty blender. So perfect your skill, know how to blend your foundation, get yourself a beauty blender, know how to blend your foundation when you're good enough to blend your foundation. So oh, so I can blend my foundation really, really well. So I need to know how to highlight and contour. Still go back to dubois, but I have my concealer here that I use for my eyebrows. I can use that to highlight. So you highlight using that. Then from there, now what is remaining? I need to contour. So if you had like a foundation, another foundation, but an eyeshadow palette that will serve you all these purposes, you didn't have to go to dubois to get yourself a foundation to do your contour. So initially, people used to do like cream contours a lot. People never used to do like powder contours. It used to be cream contour. So I'd go to dubois, get myself the darkest shade of foundation, or get myself a concealer, which was dark cocoa, which was the darkest concealer, and use that to do my contour to do that. So now already I have my brows, I have my foundation, I have my primers, and then I have now I have my concealers to do my highlight and my contour. The next thing now that I want to get is what? Face powder or my setting powder. There in dubois, obviously, there is such a powder, a fake one. They do have one. They'll sell it to you maybe at 500 shillings. It's there. And then they also have the face powder. The face powders that are in dubois are Sleek and MAC. And now they have like so many ranges. But when I used to shop there, they used to have Sleek, MAC, and I think Naked. There are so many powders. But Sleek and MAC were like, you know, the all-time thing. So I have a powder. You know, we are going slowly. So these things, you're not buying them every day or every week. The best thing about dubois is that you can manage to buy them every week, because the highest thing you could get goes for 300 shillings or, you know, 150. So after I bought all these things, now I have like a complete set. Then I started noticing, okay, so the more I do my research on makeup, the more I notice. So we do have legit products. So one foundation is going to cost me, what, how much? 1,800 shillings, the cheapest that can work for my skin. 1,800 shillings for one foundation. Do you know how many foundations that is in dubois? You go ahead, you buy. So one foundation is gonna last you like almost a year or something. So in between 1 year, you can buy some other stuff in between. So I noticed in the beginning of the year, I bought a foundation, 1,800 shillings. So I need to save up for, I need a good setting spray. So I go ahead and save for a good setting spray, which is going to cost me like 600 shillings. So I start from there. So, and then what else do I need? Okay, I need a good eyeshadow palette, of which this eyeshadow palette I still use. It still works. So what happens is that I get eyeshadow, I'm an eyeshadow junkie. So I just get eyeshadow palettes. Sometimes I go bankrupt because I want to buy every eyeshadow palette that comes out. But it's not necessary, by the way. It's not necessary. You don't have to buy everything. And then also another thing, you don't have to buy everything that every YouTuber or every makeup artist uses, because it is not about the product that they use. It's all about the technique. So you have to master your techniques, and then you can use anything. By the way, when you master your technique, you can definitely use anything, even if it's trash, and you can get a complete beautiful look. So it depends. So get yourself like just perfect your skill, okay? Perfect your skill and then use anything you can get yourself into. But if the dubois is favorable to you, just use it. Me, I don't have anything against anyone using stuff from the dubois, by the way, because at the end of the day, 90% of us have started from there. This original makeup, let me not lie to you. People tell you that 1800 is affordable. To me, it wasn't. 1800 shillings wasn't affordable for me to do makeup. It's still not affordable for me to do makeup, because at some point, these makeup gigs don't even come along when you need them. But what happens when I get makeup gigs, I charge a client 1500, then I'll be left with 1000 shillings after I have removed my maybe savings or my expenses, and I figure out 1000 shillings cannot even buy me foundation, so I have to wait for another client to get another foundation. I don't know if you guys, I know I'm talking too much, but all I want to say is that do not pressure yourself. You don't have to go and get all these things, all of them together. What you want to do is perfect each skill as you go, so that when you buy something, you don't regret why you bought it. Because sometimes I can stay here and tell you to go get yourself a Revlon foundation, it's good, and you don't even know how to apply a foundation. So how am I helping you in that? Know how to do your skill, then now from there, go into this, you know, get your expensive brands or get your, you know, good brands, because there's no need for you to buy something and then waste it when you don't know how to do stuff, okay? That is the only thing I can advise you. That's how you make up your makeup kit. Just buying things slowly by slowly, and then at the end of the day, you're going to notice you have a lot of things, because you don't buy all these things together at once. It is impossible. You can't do that. It is expensive, it is impossible, and it is just, it's not even making sense. There's no way you can just wake up one day and decide, oh, I want to learn how to do makeup, and then you go to a makeup store, buy an eyebrow pencil, buy an eyeshadow, buy all these things because you saw CJ using this, I wanna, you know, it doesn't make sense. Just start somewhere, start with your brows, perfect your brows, go to your eyes, perfect your eyes, then go to your face, do your foundation, perfect your face, then now start saving for these things. I even at some point had a home bank. I used to save, like, I'm saving for makeup, you know, like, so at the end of the year, how much have I saved? So I go and buy all these things that I need, because I know at the end of the one, if I buy one thing, it's gonna last me like for an entire year or even more. So that is how I build up my makeup kit, really. I didn't wake up and just go and buy things all at once, because I couldn't do that. I couldn't afford it. So I don't know. I don't even know if I've made sense anyway. But I always feel like if I want to talk about something, I just talk about it, whether it makes sense sometimes or it doesn't make sense. But I hope I have made sense. Just perfect a skill as you go. Buy stuff as you go. But do not get pressured that to do your brows or to have a good foundation, you must have Revlon. So I must save. I'm having all this pressure to go get 1800 shillings to go buy Revlon. What is it? Just buy what you can afford at the moment. Then just start saving for something that you want to get. I hope this video helps out somebody, even if it's just a lot of talking and a lot of, you know, things that do not make sense. But that's just how you start. Just kidogo kidogo, kidogo kidogo, ujaza kibaba. Not everything all at once. So yeah, I'm gonna see you guys next time. I have a video on this look. I'm gonna link it up here for you guys to go check it out. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time with another video of I don't know what you guys are gonna suggest down below, and I'm gonna share everything that you want me to share with you guys over there. Bye bye.